107.5, home of that Summer Jam 17. Dr. Darius, what up, though? Mila J, what up, though, my baby?
What up, though?
Welcome to the D.
Thank you for welcoming me to the D.
You, of course, you're from L.A., right?
I am, born and raised.
Born and raised in L.A. Now, we were talking earlier, I said we were talking about pops and sodas. There's actually a lingo difference.
I'm saying in L.A. we say soda. We don't say pop. That's how I always know somebody is, like, not from there, like, pop. We don't say pop. But I do like the way that sounds, though. I'm going to start saying pop, I think.
Oh, he's from out of town, cuz. I'm going to wear pop at.
Why got to be cuz?
I don't know, man. L.A., I got that. Let me turn my head up to the front. I don't know. My head
no, right your hair's fine.
I bet. I don't know if you was gangbanging out there in L.A.
No, that is a misconception, okay? You watch Boys in the Hood too much.
You know what? I'm not going to lie. When I go out there, I'm going to L.A., I'm like, let me make sure I have too much blue in this shirt, too much red in this shirt. I'm going to just have all white.
You want to be real neutral. Yeah, like, we're gray. You know what I'm saying?
Gray?
I'm saying, like, you know, something that doesn't have any color.
Oh, okay.
No, but it's not that bad.
That's what's up. Nah, look, I was just checking your video out on Vimeo.
Really? Thank you for that view.
Nice view. And actually, speaking of the view, man, I actually clicked on the ad, too, so you know that Google check finna come in, too.
Okay,
you know?
Okay. That's what's up. Good looking out. Good looking out. Clap.
I'm going to play some of the song right here. I think it's really dope. The concept of the video is really dope.
Thank you.
If anybody doesn't have your Instagram or your Twitter, tell them what it is.
Yes, follow me, M-I-L-A-J. That's Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. More active on Instagram, but yeah, everything's M-I-L-A-J across the board.
I was going to ask you, what's your favorite? Twitter, Instagram?
Definitely Instagram. I think it's just so much easier. Post, filter, boom, let's go. You know what I mean? And you can comment and do all that. I don't think it's cool, though, that people can DM you and they can see that you've read it.
Oh, yeah.
They need to change that feature, dude.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, yeah.
Don't you agree?
Yeah, I mean, I should be able to check it without you seeing that I checked it.
Exactly.
If I want to ignore it, I can't even damn ignore it.
Exactly. Like, let me get back when I want to get back.
Yeah.
But if I want to get back, right?
Yeah, right.
I think that'll be in the new update, probably.
I mean, so the safest thing is just to be like, man, I ain't even see it, bro.
Man, yeah, you know. Somebody else has my password to my account, too. Sometimes they check it for me. You know, that could maybe work. You know, I don't know. No, I wouldn't buy it if somebody told me that.
or no. Mila J in the building. Introduce this new Dre right here. And if you haven't seen the video, I'm finna tweet it out, man. Go check it out. It's dope.
Yes, go check it out. But right now, we're about to get into it. It's called Smoke Drink Breakup on iTunes now and Vimeo. Let's go.
Smoke Drink Breakup. All right, we're going to get into that right after this, man. Check it out. It's Hot 107.5.
Yeah.
Either we smoking or we drinking or we at each other's throat.
breaking up. Now, explain the concept of that. How did you come up with that joint right there?
Well, you know, basically it was inspired by, a past relationship that I'm not in anymore. Obviously, we broke up. But, you know, it's just pretty much realizing that, dang, we don't get along unless we're high. Like, when we're sober, you know, I'm just like, ugh, you're whack. So, yeah, we had to break up.
Any relationships out there like that, please hit us up right now, 313-298-1075 when y'all sober. It's some BS, but when y'all on that level,
yeah,
it's everything.
Exactly. Oh. Unfortunately. So, you know, I had to get out of that.
What you want, baby? You want some Coney Island?
Actually, I don't think I've ever had that before.
Sober like, you won't never cook.
That is true, because I do not cook, okay? I can cook like two things, though.
What's your specialties?
Tacos. And like salmon, spinach, and brown rice. Those are my two meals.
I like number two.
Tacos
is like real basic.
Yeah, I'm about to say, somebody told me tacos don't count. They're like, that does not count as a meal. I'm like, honey, yes, it does. Trust me, my tacos are on another level.
I mean, seriously. But you've been on the road since like, what? How long you been? You started off dancing when you were like five, right?
Yeah. I started off dancing and then, but my father was a musician, so I was always like surrounded by music and just had that outlet because our like garage was turned into a complete like full out studio with a booth and everything. Mm. And just a lot of family friends were in the industry, so it just kind of happened naturally. Like through dancing, I would go on different auditions that happened to be like music videos. So it just kind of, you know, ended up meshing.
So what type of dancing did you like, ballet, tap, or was just what?
Yeah, it was all that. It was ballet, tap, it was jazz, African, and hip-hop.
What would you say the money is right now? Because you know some parents out here has got their kids dancing. Like, what direction should they send their kids in right now?
Well, first of all, you shouldn't go in a direction for money.
Why not?
Okay? You should never do that, okay?
Got the bills!
But still, no, I mean, no, because honestly, with kids, if they're not passionate about it, they're not going to do it anyway. Like, the funny part is, I was naturally actually really good at ballet. Like, I was just a natural born ballerina, but I did not want to do ballet. I was like, oh, like, I don't want to be uptight. I have to wear my hair in a bun. And I just felt stiff. I'm like, no, I'd rather do hip hop. But it's like, everybody was trying to push me to do ballet. But I'm like, no. So they got to love it or else it's not, it, you know, it's not going to work because that's grueling. Like, we were dancing like 5 days out of the week, like, you know, for 3 hours.
Did you have time for like boyfriend and school and like prom?
Yeah, I had time for that sometimes.
Did you like go to regular school or were you homeschooled?
I went to real school up until the seventh grade. And then seventh grade, I did home study. Nice. I still went to the prom, but it was kind of whack because I didn't really know anybody. Yeah. It was just the home school that I would have went to, and we knew the principal. So it was real, you know, there was no emotional connection, so it was like whack.
Dang, you went wrong. You went home right after the prom.
Yes, right after. What are you supposed to do after the prom?
Not go home. Come on, man.
I definitely went home.
Let's keep it 100. Mm-hmm. Janae Aiko, that's your sister?
Yes, that's my baby sister.
And a group. Why don't y'all put a group together? Maybe like a, you know, sister duo thing.
Actually, I started off in a group with my older sister at the time. At the time, Janae was so much smaller, it just would have looked weird, I think. I mean, even though, like, there's five of us and we're all, like, a year and a half apart. Mm-hmm. But it just, I don't know. At the time, she was like a baby, so it was me, my older sister, and another girl we danced with.
So you really, y'all then, got something in the works, you just don't want to say it right now.
No, I'm saying we haven't recorded nothing yet, but you know, you never know. I'm sure when the time is right, it'll go down.
Now, I was reading that, you know, you've been doing this for a while and you know, kind of took a break for a minute. Talk about some of the thing. Well, talk about, because when you're taking that break, you kind of like, man, should I give it up? Mm-hmm. Should I go back? What was that process for you?
Well, it was never, I never walked away from it. Like, I'm done. Like, I'm going to find something else. That was never, ever, like, an option. Yeah. It was definitely a time, though, I did want to break because I had been in situations where it was setbacks. You know what I mean? Like, I had groups, a single come out, one video come out. You know what I mean? Setback. You know, labels change, group breaks up, whatever.
Hate that.
But I was always in a group. And so I felt like, honestly, it happened for a reason, I feel, because I felt like I was able to develop myself as a solo artist because I was never that. You know what I mean? Prior to that. So it's like I came into my own. I started writing. You know what I mean? I was able just to focus on who I was as an artist. And then on top of that, I was in the industry since I was younger. So I went and I did find other interests for the time being. Like I got into skincare. So I went and got my esthetician license and, you know, and just was working like, you know, two full-time jobs. And
is
just
that like the, was like my Mary Kay lady?
No,
it's not a Mary Kay lady.
My bad.
Estheticians do like facials and like waxing. And, you know, it's all about skincare. You know what I mean? They keep, you know,
face,
and it's a little bit of massage in there.
How's mine? I'm straight.
Yeah. You have actually some decent skin. You know what I mean? But yeah.
Thank you. Mila J's in the building, ladies and gentlemen. Hit on that Instagram and that Twitter right now.
MILAJ.
Like Mila J is in the building.
Yes, yes.
We, you know, wish you could stay here and maybe perform live and hang out. But Summer what? Jam 17. I mean, I don't know what you're doing Saturday.
What am I doing Saturday? Oh, I'm going to be in Chicago.
Right out the street, so you can just come right back. You know what I'm saying? So 3 hour, 4 hour
Columbus,
drive.
My bad.
It's on the way.
I don't even know the schedule.
You know what I'm saying? Hey.
That's what's up. Hold on, I got somebody.
That's what Jason's for.
I got somebody. That's the screen I was talking about. I got somebody on the line who want to actually holler at you real quick. Hello?
Yeah, I wanted to talk to you about your son. I'm totally like, I cannot stand my kids dad. Not unless they are grown or drunk.
You see what I'm saying? Unfortunately.
Happy what's your name?
Right, you can't even function, and that's a horrible. That's horrible.
Right, it's horrible. Sure.
Exactly. Yeah, and then you only got to break up once.
Yeah. There it is. Thanks for calling.
Thank you for calling.
She from LA. You know what a good kush is too. You know what I mean?
You know what I'm saying?
Somebody come on, girl. I got that. Fine. No, you don't. No,
like,
you don't.
No.
Been out of town. Somebody hit you with a weird name. I got that.
I got that.
I got that Waka Flocka Flame OG.
Okay.
Nah, Mila J is in the studio, man. If you haven't heard, I just played her song not too long ago. It is called
Smoke, Drink, Break Up.
Yeah, I was going to mess it up. Smoke, Drink, and Break Up. She's basically saying what the caller just said.
Yes.
That she can't get along with her significant other unless we put one in the air.
Exactly.
Now, you actually going to a hookah bar tonight. You like hookah?
You know what's funny is that even though I smoke, I've never smoked hookah before. It's weird.
Wow.
I've never tried hookah.
Nice.
Somebody just gave me a free little hookah pen too, but I've never tried it. I just always thought like, what? Because what is it? Like, you're smoking fruit. Like, what's the point?
A hookah pen? I've never heard of
a hookah pen. That's yeah, like the little, you put it inside of it.
That's that wax, ain't it?
Could be.
I mean, you could put wax in there.
Now, growing up, you got sisters growing up, all of you obviously sing and dance.
Yes.
Did y'all have any, like, competitions in the house? Or?
No, we were never competitive against each other. I think that's
just, like, friendly competition.
No, I mean, not even that. It was like, you know, it's all love.
Like, girl, you can't hit this note.
No. I feel we're all so different that it's just we, you know, appreciate each other's, you know, differences and whatnot.
Y'all ain't sing for shotgun, nothing riding in the car?
Now, that we would battle for. Now, riding in the front or going to get the mail and answering the door. I don't know why growing up that was a big thing to be like, no, I want to get the mail. I want to answer the door. And I still fight for the front seat. There and it. I get it, too.
There it is. Mila J is in the studio, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
Just played a new joint. You got a website, or if anybody want to get in contact with you?
Yes. All my social media is Mila J, M-I-L-A-J, and then my website is Project Mila J.
That's what's up.
Yep, yep.
We got to get you back to Detroit, hang out a few times, you know?
Yes, y'all got to show me what the D do.
I know you want to show you what the D do.
You know.
Pause.
Y'all know what I mean.
Show what the D do.
I set myself up for that one.
You sure did. All right, I think that's kind of it. I think I kind of asked everything that I wanted to ask.
Are you sure?
Yeah, you single?
I am single, actually.
What type of guys do you like?
I don't really have a type as far as what they look like, but they have to be funny.
Okay, but look, do you know that you only come to the relationship only knowing how to make two meals?
Okay, but how many men are walking around that know how to change a flat tire or build something? You know, men always are like, can you cook? It's like, well, can you build?
Yeah, we can build.
You know what I mean? Can you fix my tire if it's flat?
Shout out to Home Depot.
Or are you going to call AAA?
I'm going to call AAA if I need to.
No. I'm going to need you to be a man and figure it out. You know what I'm saying? And IKEA furniture don't count. If you know how to put together IKEA furniture, that don't count. Just like my tacos don't count. Thank you.
All right, we're going to come to your house and sit on milk crates. Mila J, thanks for stopping through, my baby.
Thank you for having me.
Time in Detroit.
I am. So far, so good.
All right, man. It's Hot 107.5 coming up now.